Hey, we got a lot to talk about on this one. Ricochet, Tessa Blanchard, Sami Callihan, Reno Scum, Alberto el Patron. Let's do this. This is BQ when I do this for the Impact Wrestling fan.
Well, how about instead of focusing on those yahoos, you focus yourself on Eli Drake?
All right, first things first, Impact Wrestling fans, if it's your first time here on the channel, please hit that subscribe button. We just hit 2,000 subscribers, and we're looking to go up, up, up. So please hit that subscribe button. We're talking Impact every week. So first order of business, Reno Scum, gone from the company. Adam Thornstow announced this on Twitter. If you know me, I'm very disappointed about it. I was very pissed off because this was my favorite tag team. I was at the set of tapings where they debuted, so I became very connected to them. I like their in-ring style. I like the look. I thought they had a lot of potential, and I thought there was a lot of potential in a feud with LAX. It seems like OVE came aboard, and they decided we're going to move forward with OVE instead of Reno Scum, something I think is a big mistake. Not saying that I dislike OVE, I just don't think they're as over with the fans as the company thinks they are, and to position them as the top babyface tag team right now, before it's their time, I don't think is a super smart idea. But they have a lot of potential, and there would have been a lot of potential in a match between OVE and Reno Scum, I think, as far as just a great work tag team match with a lot of really innovative offense. So I'm really disappointed about this. This was a team that was excited to be there. Again, I just liked them a lot. I thought there was so much they could have done with them, and it seems like in a cost-cutting move, they have parted ways with Reno Scum. It almost seems like they're parting ways with anyone associated with Jeff Jarrett, which I don't think is, you know, as a fan, the smartest thing in the world to do, because there's some talent that he brought over and there's stuff that you can do with this talent. I'm cool with seeing new faces and all that, but there's been a lot of turnover and every set of tapings is new people, and then those same people leave, and I'm ready as a fan to know who is going to be on this roster, what the roster is going to be for the knockouts, the tag teams, the males as far as each division, and I want to know what these rosters are going to be and move forward. I'm done with the departures. I seriously am. Speaking of OVE, there has been some talk that Sami Callihan could appear at either the set of tapings or at Bound for Glory, maybe inserting himself in the angle with OVE and LAX. I haven't really been paying attention to the social media lately, but last I saw, they kind of been pushing this OVE and LAX match as a handicap match. So it only makes sense that OVE may have some backup. Sami Callihan would be a great name. He's someone my family have seen in person a couple times. We really like him. I know my wife likes him quite a bit. And I've said it many, many times. The company needs to get their hands on some of these indie darlings if they want to see some new eyes on a product moving forward. And I think he would be a great addition. I really do. If they could handle him the right way. And if they factor him to this OVE thing, I think that would be very smart. So there's been some talk about what they're going to do with Alberto El Patron at the pay-per-view. They've been considering adding him to the main event as a triple threat. I can see this happening. I hate saying that, but I really can. I'm not convinced that the company feels like Eli Drake versus Johnny Impact is a strong enough main event. I think they're going to mess with it in one way, shape, or form. You remember a couple years ago when they had Galloway and EC3 in the main event at Bound for Glory? I think it was 2 years ago, maybe three. At the last minute, they added Matt Hardy to the match, and Jeff Hardy as the referee, and then Matt Hardy won the match. Now, I don't really quite remember that far back as far as some of the details that surrounded that, but I kind of felt like as a fan watching that they weren't confident enough with Drew Galloway in the main event at the time, and I could see that happening this time, and I really don't. There's also talk about him being the special guest referee for this. Will have a major role on the Bound for Glory card, and I think he's going to insert himself in one way, shape, or form into the global championship main event. I hope he doesn't mess with it, but I really think that he is. There's been some talk that Ricochet, aka Prince Puma, is in negotiations with Impact Wrestling. I really don't want people to get too excited over this, because I think as much as we would all love to see him there, I really think he's possibly too big for the company, if I'm being real with you guys. As far as a talent, I think he's probably someone that has his sights set on bigger things, But I'm just speculating when I say that. I 100% would love to see him in the company. And I think if they negotiate the right deal with him and creatively, you know, don't just throw him in the X division, but creatively say, hey, we're gonna put you here in the title picture, because in Lucha Underground, he was the man. So you can't just throw him in the X division. But I know he does watch Impact Wrestling. He has fans, especially, I mean, not fans, but he has friends in the company, especially Matt Sydal. And I think he would just be an amazing addition, but they can't just do X division stuff with him. Maybe a little bit, but you got to do something really, really big with him, and that would be huge. I know a lot of the WWE fans right now expect him to debut in the Royal Rumble. All I have to say to you is, just because AJ Styles debuted in the Royal Rumble one year, it doesn't mean that every Royal Rumble is going to have these huge surprises, because they don't, because that's the only huge surprise they've ever had, really. And Ricochet, again, much like Sami Callihan, is still kind of an indie darling. So him debuting like in the Royal Rumble makes absolutely no sense, because those casual fans may not know who he is. But this would be huge. It would be absolutely huge. And some of these cost-cutting measures may make sense now if they were able to add him. So I want to know what you guys think. I would imagine 100% of you want to see him with the company. Now, speaking of Ricochet, his girlfriend Tessa Blanchard, it was reported several weeks ago that they are in talks with her joining the Knockouts division. It seems like she is expected to debut at the set of tapings after Bound for Glory. That is the rumor at the moment. If you're not familiar with Tessa Blanchard, she is seriously, I hate using that term, hottest free agent, but as far as female wrestlers on the independent circuit, she is a hot free agent. She is really, to me, for my taste, you know, one of the top two or three females they could bring on board. Rachel Ellering is another one that I think is right up there with her, 1 and 1A. As far as a young talent that would take this Knockouts division to the next level. But Tessa Blanchard, if you get her down, now that really lays the groundwork for Ricochet coming over. So that is really important right there if they're able to do it. But Tessa Blanchard has a great look, very talented, and with the departure of Taryn Terrell, and who the hell else knows who's departing, I think at this point you gotta bring her on board, and you gotta probably bring her as a heel, because on the babyface side, you still got Rosemary, you still got Allie, and I mean, if they want to replace Gail Kim with her hypothetically, then that could happen too. But with the departure of Taryn, you know, I kind of feel like, you know, they need to throw someone into that slot, unless they feel like LVN or Diamante can move forward into that position. So we're going to see going forward. Leave a comment. Let me know what you guys think about all the rumors, all the news. This is some good rumors this time. Not that negative crap. I'm expecting some negative crap to come before Bound for Glory, because it always does. But everything here so far, Sami Callihan, Ricochet, Tessa Blanchard, this is all good stuff. The only thing I'm really disappointed is the Reno Scum departure. So please hit subscribe on the channel, and we'll talk to you guys soon. And we'll be previewing Bound for Glory very soon.